thought we were meeting for lunch.
Well, we are, but I decided to meet you along the way. Come on.
Wallace, it's been 4 months since she left. Are you going to do anything?
I feel so little. I feel so useless.
How do you think this guy in the yellow suit is going to react?
He's going to piss himself.
Let's go.
Dr. O'Hara! Dr. O'Hara! We got a few questions for you, Dr. O'Hara. Dr. Fabian O'Hara.
It's Professor Fabian O'Hara, you twit.
Dr. Dyson says that you're building the fusion core as a profiteering scheme for the energy brokering firms.
I have no plan to respond to Mr. Dyson.
Is it also true that you fired your friend Dr. Wallace Wendell over a dispute about who should control the fusion core?
That argument never happened, and no one fired Wallace.
With the success of the asteroid torpedo adverting an asteroid hit on Earth, do you think the public will readily accept the fusion core? It being based on the asteroid torpedo's technology?
The fusion core will provide free electricity for the whole planet. That's why it'll be accepted. Now, please, I really have to go.
Dr. O'Hara, one more question. Is it true that Drake Dyson threatened to kill you?
And addressing the question of particle discharge, it has been postulated by the Berkeley Institute of Science that this device will emit neutrinos during any acceleration of the fusion core. This may have been true in tests, however, when held at a constant burn rate, any emission is negligible. The fusion core is a centrifuge spun at near the speed of light, inside of which is contained the fusion skin. This fusion skin is a string of burning hydrogen forced to fuse into heavier elements. Energy is drawn off the skin by the Dysonic membrane, named after Freeman Dyson, whose Dyson sphere was the inspiration for this invention.
Does his great nephew get a cameo?
Regis, stop recording. Drake, I'm honored. I thought you'd given up on the project.
I believe my exact words were
asinine and ludicrous.
Except when the United Nations and the US fully financed the project.
You're right.
Coupled with Russia donating the Eagle Bay mineshaft.
Is the mineshaft in the center of the Earth?
Drake, how may I help you?
I came to see how I could help you.
I heard about Dr. Wendell. I want to see if my services could be valued.
No?
Is this because I don't agree with your politics?
Politics? Isn't that what they call fanaticism these days?
The phrase is communism.
I recently lost a good friend, and I don't need to replace Wallace with an enemy.
I'm not your enemy, nor is Dr. Wendell dead. What is this finalism that you've developed?
Finalism? What is that? One of your Dysonisms?
Finalism? You sidelined me on the asteroid torpedo project, and you slighted me when it came time to apply for the fusion core patent. And you pretty much told Wendell to screw off because he was having women problems. What's next? You gonna fire Regis because he smokes pot?
Regis, you smoke marijuana?
Frequently.
Fabian, talk to me. Why have you decided to go in alone on the Fusion Core patent? This is a shared project. Why are you trying to consolidate control to yourself?
Because I will give away the energy it creates for free.
Then we're in agreement. The Fusion Core will be free to all of mankind.
No, we are not in the capacity that I will not let the core be used as an extension for your communist agenda.
What? Are you going to be the proverbial Santa Claus, dispensing gifts of free power to all the people, without any condition or purpose?
I'm not going to condone. I don't believe in communism, Drake. You do. You have never liked competitive pursuits, and you see everything associated with capitalism as a degrading experience that makes people evil.
Well, doesn't it?
No, it does not. Competition is what keeps men whole. Frankly, the fusion core has nothing to do with our personal morals.
So this is it. We're done working together.
We were done when you said you could use the fusion core to enforce international socialism. What right do we have to force our opinions on others?
Okay. Fine. Have it your way. Squander the fusion core, which I helped design, and any hope you may have in unifying the world. But know this, Fabian. I will be there every step of the way to fight you, to resist you, to impede you ever so long as you continue to shut me and my message out.
I will boil in hell longer than I will ever let you share control with me!
Fine. You know, Dr. O'Hara, Wallace, he looked to you like a son looks to a father. And the one time he needed you as a father the most, you told him to go to hell.
What was I supposed to say? He was heartbroken over a woman.
Goodbye, Regis. Dr. O'Hara.
Get out!
Coming or something? I thought the two of you broke up a year ago. That's not cool, Josh. Of course it's not cool. You've been cheating on me for 2 weeks just to dump me? It really hurts that you would say that. I may be 34, and you don't have to respect 34 women, but go to hell for saying that I'm too old for you.
Hours you monitor a train system of a supernova?
Well, Reggie, let me explain. The computer has extrapolated a region of space that the search line came from. In here.
Now let's go to the rainbow room.
It will be impossible to determine the origin of the neutrino surge until the star goes supernova.
Why can't we just trace the surge's origin?
The surge terminated after only 17 minutes.
Oh, the star has already gone. about supernova? Has blown up?
No, it's something like this. Normally, when a star is going supernova, we get a steady transmission of neutrinos that gradually gets larger and larger until the star actually explodes. In this case, we got a steady transmission of neutrinos for exactly 17 minutes before it just stopped. This is the likely reserve space where the neutrinos originated from. This being the most likely system, a system called CRMM114, which is approximately 40 light years.
I know that. In the morning, before you leave, call Dr. Jones at university and tell her everything you found out. I'd like a report on what she says, what you find out, and what you think. Have it to me by the end of the week.
Should I give Fabian a copy?
No! I will give Fabian a copy myself. When I feel the time is right.
It is my knowledge that Fabian O'Hara has motioned for a startup date 2 months ahead of schedule.
That's right, as the members of this committee surely know.
The fusion core is less than a year old and has not undergone any rigorous testing. This stupid fool wishes to forego months of tests to make sure the fusion core is ready and bring it online immediately. That's right, isn't it?
Mr. Dyson, have you at all considered the arguments the Indian government has made in favor of full power-up?
No. I have not considered the arguments. I have only considered sound scientific evidence, not the ranting of an overpopulated country.
Sir, I must say I am offended.
Oh, indeed. May I continue? Now, can we address item 158? Paragraph A, subparagraph C. How do we account for these discharges? And how do we account for the expended fuel that is used up on the reaction surface?
Let me address your point, sir.
I would be very glad if you would.
Don't be so cocky. First, particle discharge only occurs when the core is being accelerated or fueled. Second, fused hydrogen is removed from the core.
An interlock that prevents the buildup of heavy elements on the skin. Members of the committee, it is clear that the product is unfinished. The fusion core is not ready to go online.
The core is only unfinished because of Dr. Dyson's unnecessary additions. It'll only be ready when he says it's ready.
You borrowed the design of the asteroid torpedo project without making any safety modifications.
The asteroid torpedo is a sophisticated hydrogen bomb. However, the fusion core is a vastly more complicated and impressive device. Dr. Dyson had no hand in making this.
In addition to these technical screw-ups, have you considered the impact the fusion core will have on everyone, on the Earth, on all of the people in it? Have you considered this at all?
Yes, indeed. Fusion Core Corporation predicts over the next 7 years savings totaling $9 trillion to the population of Earth due to the free electricity provided by the fusion core.
This is very practical considering the increase in oil costs.
How many starving Kenyans buy oil? The fusion core will only drive the gap between the rich and the poor even wider.
So if the fusion core is so damn unsafe because of how badly I built it, why are you trying to use politics as a reason not to start it up?
Reeves, ever since your phone call, I've made some of my own, and nobody can answer your question. And are you Dr. Vicksburg?
Yes, I am.
You're a specialist in astrophysics?
Yes. Currently,
BA from Iowa, PhD from Cornell, currently doing research at the University of Syracuse, I believe. That's about it, isn't it?
Actually, I was going to tell you that I'm currently training to compete with the Olympic swim team.
You're serious? Are you a swim team?
Yes.
Well, I feel like a complete ass.
Most people aren't up to Olympic competition.
Sounds like the physicist you once instructed.
Don't even bring his name up.
I haven't seen him in 5 years and I told him this was his future. This pathetic shard of a man.
Wendell?
Dr. Valeria Vicksburg. You submitted a report to me.
I submitted a report to my superior, Dr. Rodriguez. Did he give you a copy?
He gave it to me for review. Yes, I read it.
Hello.
Whatever that was, notwithstanding.
All this way, you haven't said anything.
How come you didn't tell me?
Tell you what? What didn't I tell you? That he worked for your research group?
You're damn right! Why didn't you tell me he worked for me?
Because I didn't know you hated his guts.
I don't hate him, but I loathe what he's become.
You loathe what he has become? Isn't that bullshit?
Look at him. Look at him and tell me that he once was a prodigy in the world of astrophysics. I'll see you tomorrow.
And the distance at which they originated, I conclude that the star was much too thin for it to have gone supernova. It should have expanded into a nebula.
Yet clearly the readings are consistent with a supernova.
Or an asteroid torpedo.
Dr. Vicksburg, are you ready to split?
No. You said the neutrino surge lasted for exactly 17 minutes?
That's right.
I can't explain.
What is wrong with the computer?
Reggie, we got another one.
We have another neutrino surge. Same magnitude as before, with the same resonant frequency.
No, Wally, this one is 20% bigger.
Checking it with before.
Probably one of DJF-1982. Or CRMM-114.
Does anyone else think that these two surges are from the same system?
I think that it's a foregone conclusion that these surges originate from the same region of space and are artificial in origin.
Foregone conclusion? I wouldn't up and jump to any conclusion so hastily.
Just trust me, I have an intuitive sense about this one.
I don't trust intuitive senses unless they are my own.
Then what's your intuitive sense about this?
Delta 6.
Delta 6. What the hell does that mean?
Dr. Vicksburg, are you ready to go?
Actually, if Wally would give me a ride, I'd like to stay here and work on something.
On what? There's nothing to do here.
Well, for one, I'd like to send an email to Jeannie Jones. She can help us.
Just let me finish your email for you, and you can go home.
Yeah, and besides, Valeria, I'd like to get out of here. I'm getting tired.
Very well.
Dr. Wendell?
Yes?
It'd be in your best interest to make yourself scarce at the university, particularly the physics research lab where Fabian's at.
Haven't I always?
There's a first time for everything.
Goodbye, Wally. Send me a carbon copy of whatever you're sending, Jeannie Jones. Good night.
Good night.
Yes, I am one of the lead five on the project.
Do you really believe it's a form of alien communication?
Absolutely. It is only a matter of time before we decipher the code to read the message.
But how is it that Delta 6 does not yet know the origin?
We are very close to an answer, but we will need some other electromagnetic waves to compare the transmissions to.
How was your date with Christy?
It sucked.
She seemed like such an interesting girl, though.
Yeah, but I'm not a nice guy.
That's not what she said. She was really interested in you.
Not interested enough. Good night, Dr. Vicksburg.
Can't expect to get laid all the time, Dr.
Christine, were you able to infiltrate Fabian's team?
No, we just did not ask for a second date.
How's the lobbying campaign?
Sir, you have the support of the British Parliament, but neither China nor our own Congress seem to want to delay the startup of the Fusion Corps.
Sir, did you want to continue with the infomercial?
Of course. We can't have Fabian squandering my invention.
Sir, should we approach Dr. Wendell and see if he'll support your side?
Better not risk it. He doesn't believe in communism.
Will you plan to address Wall Street about the economic policy you have in mind for the Fusion Corps?
Christine, that would be like preaching abstinence to prostitutes. The only economic policy of the Fusion Corps would be free power to socialist nations that suppress capitalistic abuses of deficit spending and inequality in public wealth. The only question is, how am I going to get control of it?
We've gone over this four times now, and I fear when we go to full power up, we'll have the same argument again.
Why not increase the fuel load when the centrifuge slows?
Meltdown risk. When the fusion core slows, we'll remove fuel and seal the chamber off, letting the remaining matter superburn on the fusion skin. This eliminates meltdown risk and keeps the injectors from fusing when you overload the core. Even if we overfuel, the excess will burn off. And this extra combustion could cause a chain reaction. The core could collapse.
This is the addendum to the original report I composed. I haven't read the original, but thanks. I'll read this when I have some free time.
Dr. Jones. No, Indiana is not here.
I'll take this one. Hello? Gloria, how's my old lab partner?
I'm swell. Did you get my email?
Email? How's the hellos and so on?
Jean, I see you every week or so. Cut the crap and tell me if you got the email. And tell me if you got a date with that handsome doctor.
Yes and no.
Thank you, Dr. Jones.
Yes, sir. You know Dr. Wendell, right?
Yeah, I met him last week.
You know Dr. Wendell? Yeah, he sent me an email. He said all the surges were 17 minutes long.
Let me forward you a copy of a report.
Oh, I got it. Wallace sent me a copy of his attachment. Not a bad-looking guy. Could use a hair transplant.
That's me.
I have to go now.
Dr. Jones. When you asked me to find Hubble telescope images,
the three solar systems, I thought that perhaps you were being thorough. But listening to this theory of yours, I now think that you're being absolutely ridiculous.
Then how would you explain two identical neutrino pulses lasting the exact same length of time?
They're not identical. You said one was 20% bigger. But I like what you have to say, nonetheless.
Good. When can I expect you to inspect the pictures from CRMM114, DJS 1982?
Inspect? You never asked for that.
Think of it as a favor from me. I think you'll find a solar system that seems to be missing a planet. Thank you.
Dr. Hare?
Yes.
Dr. Wendell called me today.
I figured he would. Do you know about the third nuclear search? I got the message just a few minutes ago.
I've been thinking about the three neutrino spikes, and I made the observation that two of them, the second and third, have occurred at periods of fluctuation in the fusion core.
Yeah, I got the email. I don't know what to make of it.
I was curious, could you find out if there is a similar connection between the fusion core and the first spike?
So that's really not my thing.
Exactly, a fresh perspective.
Has escalated with the brutal assassination of the entire parliament when two men drove truck bombs into the capital. We go live to the Unchav region of Iso del Turdistan.
My god, the fury of combat simmers like the lean muscle of an angry people. Just 10 feet away there was a gunfight in that building. I'm sorry we don't have that on film for you, but it's like we're
bodies, mutilated corpses, violence and death!
Jack, when did you first develop this theory?
Well, I first became aware of it, Mandrake, during the physical act of love.
Huh.
Yes, a profound sense of fatigue, feeling of emptiness followed. Luckily, I was able to interpret these feelings correctly. Loss of essence. I can assure you it has not recurred, Mandrake. Women sense my power, and they seek the life essence. I do not avoid women, Mandrake.
Yeah.
But I do deny them my essence.
I understand completely, yes.
Do you really? Pulse, what the hell are you doing here? You.
No. You. I always know you had a soft spot for this loser, but I didn't know he was so deaf with the ladies.
He's a man of many talents, even if he became a loser. You can't condemn him now. I need him too badly for you to dispose of him. He has done nothing to deserve you.
Who says that I'm going to kill him? Or rather, who says that you're going to kill him?
The last person you came as...
Your doctor, as I remember.
Yeah, you came as my doctor, and you told me to kill him.
But you're not going to kill Wallace.
Why are you here then? It's Wallace, if I'm not going to kill him.
You know why I'm here! You like what Dyson had to say, don't you?
Yeah, that's right. Makes sense.
Yes! The words make sense, ladies and gentlemen!
It makes sense because a fusion core is bound to be controlled by someone in the future. We can't leave it to posterity's sake to prevent a Hitler from taking control.
That's bullshit and you know it. You know it! You don't buy any of that crap about, let's share the fusion core with the world, ergo, giving control to Dyson. You can only think of the master aim of my design.
You want to inflict pain on me. You bastard!
Regis, can you see the face of the man who's supposed to destroy?
I think so.
How long would you have to stay down there?
How can you? It's just a blank piece of paper.
Why don't you tell me what the riddle is? What's the punchline? No more games. Tell me how it ends.
The end is the beginning.
Damn you. Damn you!
Dyson was right. The Corps needs one person controlling it from a position of authority. You, Regis, could be that person.
But I must do something terrible first. I must take life to give life.
Just kill Fabian. Just kill him. And you'll be in charge. Forever.
But Regis, what will he do on your staff?
Good evening, Valeria.
Gentlemen.
Good evening.
I was just talking to Wallace. We have a date.
Exciting as turtle sex.
Do you want to tell her the good news?
I recently hired Wallace onto my staff.
To do what?
See, there's my point.
I mean, I'm sure Wallace will be a definite asset. I'm just curious as to what he'll be doing.
Research analysis. Look, the man just made a discovery and composed what has to be the most well-thought-out report on what could have produced it, and I felt that between that and his legendary intellect, that he could be useful.
Tell her about your plan to take over the world.
No!
Who are you talking to?
No one. No one at all.
Can anyone smell that?
What?
Cigar smell. Never mind. Certainly the report does have some interesting suggestions.
Wallace asked Gene Jones to look at the three solar systems to see if there was anything peculiar.
Anything else?
In one of the solar systems, there were minute changes in gravity pull on the planets, except for two, which didn't have any value for gravity pull after the two neutrino surges.
I'm assuming the other two systems had no gravity changes?
Right. The system in question is CRMM114.
This system is also the system the Delta 6 project identified as the source of alien contact.
They finally identified the source. What was your function on the project?
Well, Fabian, I was the one who confirmed the source, and it was Dr. Wendell's report that helped me conclude that CRMM114 was indeed the source.
How did you do it?
Never mind how I did it. Do you all see the punchline?
That the neutrino pulses were another form of alien communication.
Exactly! Think of it. Neutrinos travel faster than light itself, and perhaps these could provide us insight into their race. What they know could possibly help us prevent violence on Earth forever.
Remarkable. Think of the consequences.
What's the problem with Jean? She never shows up to meetings.
I hear kudos are in order for your nomination to the post at the Suckle Research Lab on Mars.
I was only nominated. There are 40 other people up for the position, and I'm sure I didn't get it.
Perhaps. But it looks good on a resume. Good night, Dr. Vicksburg.
Good night, Peaches.
Thank you.
Leading the news tonight is more violence in Isodeltoidistan. Going there live is our on-site reporter, Nelson Nader. Nelson, you have a local being interviewed?
Yes! This local is from the war-ravaged village of Hashim, and he says that his village was occupied by forces associated with the rebel movement. Oh my god!
You answered the question or not?
Yes.
Dr. Dyson, would you tell us, please, about the origin of the Fusion Core?
The Fusion Core was developed by myself and Dr. Wallace Wendell.
But 10 years ago, a gentleman by the name of Fabian O'Hara tried to wrestle control from us.
You know Valeria?
Yes, Wally?
You know that waiter tonight?
Uh-huh.
I think his accent was fake. I think it was just terrible. I think he was putting us on the show.
No, he was Russian.
No, he wasn't.
Your mind's been somewhere else all night. What is it?
I want to marry you.
No.
No, actually, I just wondered if you'd like to have lunch later this week, something like that. I mean, like tomorrow.
That could work.
All right. Talk to you later.
Aren't you forgetting something?
Good night.
Fabian's biggest problem is his inability to socially comprehend anyone else's state of being, anyone else's thinking. It's not that he doesn't hear what I'm saying, it's that he cannot comprehend.
Comprehend anything that he doesn't figure out on his own?
That's right. He only sees his side of the story. He doesn't let anyone else in. You know how when little kids draw pictures, and only they know what they mean. Imagine a 45-year-old man who is still in that world.
What irritates me about Fabian is his lack of sexual desire. Indeed. He's not attracted to male or female. He seems unattached to the human world, to any human desires. And he always tries to speak in a high-powered vocabulary. Well, my presentation can be demonstrated to young or old. I have something for the kiddies. Now, this is Abel Armstrong with Playtime with Dr. Dyson.
Today, I have a story for you. Come on, let's get started. Once upon a time, there was an evil man named Fabian. And a roguishly good-looking hero named Dyson. Let's see what happens.
Shut up! You don't give a damn about my precious fusion core!
A core riddled with communist flaws?
Oh, how dare you! Take that! Come back! Come back! Come back! Come back! Ah!
Oh, Dyson, stop! If you're hurting me!
He's gone.
Please, forgive me!
I'll forgive you. Silence! I'll eat you!
Dr. O'Hara.
Hello.
Wallace, I wasn't expecting you.
I was watching Dyson on television and I thought of you.
That's not a comparison, is it?
I understand why you pushed Dyson away. You cut him out of his credit to the Fusion Core. But me... You kicked me to the curb simply because I was heartbroken over Ariana.
This fusion core is going to revolutionize the world. And I couldn't have a weak-willed man, a man that couldn't stare the Dysons of this world in the eye and tell them where to go, a man that couldn't eat and breathe the fusion core for the next 10 years, making sure it worked. A man who was a manic depressant, share control with me.
I know. You couldn't have me screw it up for you, could you? The fusion core was too important. But the hell with you, Fabian. The hell with you. I was your friend. And you couldn't help me? Screw you, Fabian. I was good enough then, and I am good enough now, and I deserve to be included.
Hello? Regis, slow down.
Don't cry. Don't cry.
What are you saying? One planet disappeared after each neutrino pulse? My God. Okay, I'm heading to the lab now. I'll see you there very shortly. Join me in the lab. Regis, what more can you tell me?
I only know what Jean told me. She's down the hall.
Professor, I have a question about...
Go somewhere else. I'm busy at the moment. Is Wallace here?
No, should he be?
I asked him to come.
Neo pulses, there are two planets closely in line in orbit, as shown in the picture there. After the first two neutrino pulses, there is an automatic picture taken by the Hubble 3.
The one for monitoring known planets. Continue.
In this picture, where there should be two planets, is a massive debris field.
Gene, what about the third neutrino surge? Are there any pictures?
Well, there might be. Wallace told me to keep my eye on the neutrino pulses.
Let's see. Regis?
Yes.
Did the Delta 6 project pinpoint any of the planets?
Yes! We pinpointed the 6th and 7th planet of the system.
Those were the 6th and 7th planets of the system.
I'm sorry, my friend. Your story doesn't have a happy ending.
But what do the two neutrino pulses have to do with it?
How else are two planets going to kill themselves, then with a weapon that emits neutrinos for 17 minutes before detonating?
Dr. Harrow, though, he knows that the asteroid torpedo emits neutrinos during its arming sequence.
I know.
You could have been right, however, Regis. The neutrino surges could have been a form of helium contact.
Wallace?
Yes, sir.
Two alien civilizations, both asteroid torpedoes of 700 or 800 gigatons, and destroyed each other in acts of mutual destruction?
That's right.
Dick. God, what have I done?
I don't know what to tell you.
Wait a moment. Regis.
What?
You said that what they know could save the Earth from violence.
Sure as hell no chance of that being true, is there?
Perhaps not.
Perhaps. If the world was to be told about the death of two civilizations,
my son, why have you forsaken me?
His car.
Consider your position on this new fusion core.
How is blocking the greatest engineering invention in the past 100 years going to help our position?
You know that we'd have a complete collapse in the nuclear power industry.
We will survive.
Perhaps you should consult Dr. Dyson, field his viewpoint.
Dr. Dyson? The communist? Don't waste my time. No. The man we need to get in bed with is Fabian O'Hare. Now if you print that, I'm going to have to ask you to go to Guantanamo.
I will go to the UN and present our case, and then I will go to ISIL Deltoidistan and make peace.
That's awfully presumptuous of you.
Regis is right, Wallace. You can't honestly believe you can go there and say, behold, two planets blew up, don't make war, and there'll be peace.
It might be just that simple. Leave.
Valeria, there's something else you wanted to bring up. What was it?
Yes, your replacement at the lab, Donald Davenport, recorded the fourth neutrino pulse. This one, like the third, was not 17 minutes long, nor did it have an identifiable origin.
Be
because we cannot identify an origin, and because it is of an erratic length, I don't think we can consider it part of our present dilemma.
No, sure, that means Terry. We want to keep this to ourselves. If Dyson gets hold of this, could spell trouble for us all. Is there anything else? No, fine, I'm off. Last person out, turn off the lights, please.
Dr. O'Hara?
It's a little colder in there than I'm used to. Do I smell like cabbage?
No, you smell like fire and brimstone, like where you came from.
Uh-huh. Come on, let's go in here.
New Testament? Proverbs? You won't be needing that. Take a seat. Not on Entertainment Weekly. Some good beer. You know what I like to do? I always like to get my buds together. We like to have a kegger once in a while.
Why are you telling me this?
Now, what we like to do is tell stories. I want to tell you a story.
If I'm supposed to take over the world, how do I deal with Wallace and Fabian?
Fabian is simple. Just kill him. Wallace, however, he's not to be harmed.
What?
Don't interfere with my design. Mind your own business, and you will have control of the world in due time. Wallace is not to be harmed.
I guess you're right. I mean, how's Wallace to tame the world with words about two dying planets?
Actually, it will be that tame world that he will make for you that you will so easily conquer.
How will he achieve
Wallace peace? Wallace is key. Don't interrupt me.
No, but how will he achieve peace?
Who says he's going to achieve world peace without the help of a extraterrestrial friend like me? Sometimes a whisper in the collective ear of mankind is louder than Wallace screaming in somebody's face about world peace.
I sense a long mission ahead for me, but I don't know what to do. Fabian, the fusion core, and these planets, what does it all mean? I mean, indeed, tell me what to do. I do not know. Okay, I understand. Hello. Came around the corner and saw someone sitting here that I thought I recognized, and came over and, wow, this is something out of the blue, out of the clear blue. Nothing I would ever have expected. Wow. That's a really big book you're reading. What is it?
Maps of early Egypt.
What?
Maps of early Egypt.
Yeah, that doesn't make any sense. Why are you looking at... What do you do now? Do you look at maps of early Egypt?
Oh, it's just for fun. Helps me relax sometimes. You can trace the rivers.
So which one is this?
I'm not sure. I just flipped the page recently. Sometimes it doesn't even bother me which one I'm looking at.
I bet good money that's the Nile. You know, it's the only river in Egypt is the Nile.
Well, there are subsidiary rivers.
There are no tributaries to the Nile.
Yeah.
It's just the only river.
Fair enough.
Coming from the deep jungle of the African forest.
Wow.
Okay, maps notwithstanding, what brings you back here? Well, I don't know. I don't have any time right now to talk to you. I have a date. Gotta meet somebody. Why don't you write down all your stuff, like your email and home number and your cell phone number and your mailing address. Yeah, I think that'll be about it. I have my own website now. So I'll just give you my website.
All right.
It has all that stuff on it. It's www.wallacewindle.org. Don't ask. Hey.
Negotiate with you. I told you that a military occupation of the Fijian Corps complex was unlikely to happen.
Perhaps we can force a dialogue. I want you to get the president to meet with Fabian O'Hare, the UN Security Council, and me.
You better not forgive me if you gain control.
Well, here we are again.
Yep.
Boy, it sure is a lot of people in this class, huh?
One body plus another body equals zero mind and zero talent. The rest of the class is watching me via projection.
Isn't that clock on the wall? That's 5 minutes fast. We're going to start every day, every hour from now on, using that clock. And if you don't like it, then tough shit. Okay, let's get this bastard moving, shall we? Pragmatism in the old days was considered to be any mode of thought that was practical and led someone to a fuller, richer life. However, in the early millennials, after the collapse of postmodernism, pragmatism began to take on a new form, in the form of modern pragmatism. You see, basically, modern pragmatism is the same thing as pragmatism was, however, with this stipulation. You see, say someone murders someone in cold blood, then they take their house, and thus, that action would be practical. Thus, modern pragmatism.
Oh my god, that's so weird.
You!
Let me call you back.
What's your name?
Tracy Townsend.
See, people come from all over the world to absorb Dr. Milhouse's life essence. And maybe they're just lucky to take a piece of it home with them. However, they can't do that with you gabbing it up all the time in class. So why don't you just take your cute little behind and go. You're dropped. Sorry that little girl had to waste your time like that. Let's keep this bitch moving, shall we?
Milhouse.
Dr. Professor Emeritus Marion Milhouse, to be precise.
Okay.
But what do you need?
Who wrote the book, Hues of Darker Blue?
Well, I believe that was a fine gentleman by the name of Michael Haley. Very strapping. Tall, handsome, mysterious, brooding. Everything I look for in another man. Would someone else care to read the selection? On page 37.
Time's wasting.
She said goodbye. He said hello. He thought of her as a necessary blot on his perfect world. She provided him a momentary, passionless release, but in the morning, he would still embrace the day, reading memos, eating lunch, and saying hello to co-workers. While he would relish the fact that she slept during the waking hours and would awake to the ravenous night, free to spread her wicked charms among those who needed such charm.
What the hell is this shit?
Her end will be his beginning. Class, how is this an example of modern pragmatic literature?
Essentially, this selection
infuses
random statements in a disjointed effort to show that this guy is just using her for sex, not trying to cultivate a meaningful relationship with her.
Yes, please, go on. Very fascinating. Dr. Milhouse is interested.
In fact, it just revolves around this godlike narrator and telling you everything you need to know about the story. It really had nothing to do with modern pragmatism at all.
That was vivid, intelligent, interesting. I learned something very special about you during a little exchange, Wallace. So do you mind if Dr. Milhouse shares something with the rest of the class?
Okay.
This is so touching.
I'm sorry, Doc. I didn't mean to make you cry.
Don't worry about it. It's okay.
Hey, you could at least tell me how I was wrong.
Fuck you.
Okay, class. Dr. Milhouse is not going to grace your presence for the rest of the hour, so he's going to leave you with some interviews that he did for NBC, CBS, and the Today Show. Let us enjoy.
Pragmatic art is somewhat macabre by design. However, it is only macabre because those who are not don't realize the beauty of it. Take for an instance. A farmer goes to get bread for his wife. He stops and gets the bread and then goes home. And then he cries because he is a worthless piece of shit. Now, that would be any other art form and the audience would feel sad for him. But no. Pedestrian preoccupations of mankind have failed the pragmatic test. Pragmatism. Pragmatics. The art of being useful. The art of being practical. And the art of being beautiful. Ah, my dear chums, but you see, Beauty and oblivion go hand in hand. And that is where modern pragmatism comes into the fold. Pragmatism, life, and driving. There are three parallel lines that will eventually intersect into total and absolute beautiful oblivion. I will see you there.
Can you believe that asshole? That class was stupid.
Yeah, I could hardly believe him. Just rambles on about nothing. And did you see what he did to Tracy?
She did that to the phone.
Oh! Hi, Tracy.
Hey.
So, are you gonna drop the class?
I don't know.
Oh, well, I hope I see you around.
Hopefully.
Bye.
Bye.
Good luck with that. I took this class 5 years ago and I got a D+ in it. I figured I'd retake it now.
Man, I got a C- in chemistry last semester, but I basically just decided to call it quits and move on.
So what does a psychology major do at like 7 o'clock tonight?
Well, there's this really good Thai place on Wells Street, if you'd like to try it out with me.
I never had Thai before. Is it any good, or is it just kind of like Chinese food?
Well, it's kind of spicy, but other than that, it's a lot
of fun. So it's like Mexican food and Chinese food all rolled together?
I guess you could say that.
Then we all have an equal opportunity.
But what you're talking about is the people that were lower than 10% income bracket would gain more money, while Fabian would lose money.
It's hardly equal. Wallace.
Hello.
Wallace.
Wallace? We just Rodriguez.
Hello.
How do you do?
I'm Wallace Wendell.
Hi.
Yeah, I thought you looked familiar.
Yeah, he and I were in Scientific America together.
Hey, Fabian, have those mock-ups of the Fusion Core... Well, first of all, what have you guys been talking about?
Socioeconomics.
Everything about
okay, that. I'll bring up what I have to say then. Have the mock-ups of the Fusion Core come in yet?
Let me check my ledgers.
Mm-hmm. What were you guys in Scientific America for?
Asteroid torpedo.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Hey, Drake? Are you going to be available tomorrow night? We need to finish the mock-up for the Fusion Core.
Sure. Why can't we just do it tonight?
I got a date. I'm going to change my clothes, though. I don't want to miss that.
I should hope so. Where'd you find that ugly jersey?
It was my friend Reginald Sheets's in high school. He died a couple years ago. I wear it as kind of a remembrance.
Did he die on the field?
No, he died in a car accident. That wasn't too nice.
Hey.
Let's
try and keep it civil, please.
I'm sorry.
You say things like that, but you insult people when you say that, and you gotta work on that.
Hey, I didn't name Reginald.
Hey, everybody, I gotta get going.
Goodbye, then, Willis.
You think this is funny, man? This is serious stuff. I mean, this is life and death.
Yeah.
Careful, man. Is he a master student or something?
At times.
All right, good evening. Hello. Dr. O'Hara. You know, your voice is not very pleasant about first thing in the morning. What? You're giving me my old job back? Well, yes, I accept the job. Thank you. My old job. It's not Ariana.
Need to talk to you.
Make it quick, then.
I've been monitoring the Fusion Core.
And I don't have time for this, Jean.
But the energy spikes have been coinciding with the refueling.
It's to be expected. Don't worry about it. We'll modify the design for the replacement unit throughout in 5 years.
But isn't that dangerous?
I don't think so. No, I need to go, Jean, so I'll see you later.
Our sponsor within the Fusion Core Circle has told me that the core suffers spikes in heat output whenever it slows from its nominal rotational speed. Simply put, the fusion core periodically is run at over 100%, and this will eventually damage or destroy the core itself.
Will you confront the president with this?
Absolutely. Our sponsor is standing at the end of the room. She's come to us for exactly this reason, to prevent a disaster.
What about what he told us about Dr. Wendell's peace initiative?
Dr. Wendell? He's not predictable, and he's a manic depressant. It is a problem, but it's not ours.
What if we attack his reputation?
It's a possibility. The Defense Secretary has established a meeting with the UN Security Council, Dr. O'Hara, and myself. I will contact all of you before that meeting. Thank you.
Coffee?
Yeah, do you still take it black?
Well, I always did.
Well, Wallace, what did you want to talk about?
Where you've been. I've missed you, and for a very long time.
As for where I've been, I moved to Wyoming for a couple years after we split up. Stayed with her until we broke up. And then San Diego, and now here. As for men, you're the last that meant anything.
What about the women?
No. Is that funny?
Secretary.
Then act like it. Just get me into that meeting.
Why did he take his coat off?
These days.
Is he getting his PhD today?
Yes.
How was the last 3 years with Wallace? Assuming you have been with Wallace. Is he good?
You're demented.
Milhouse is demented. But demented is only the beginning. I hope Wallace does well in his exams.
have you been?
Doing well. You know, you really should lose the hat. Wallace, can I ask you a question?
Not the question.
Can I ask you another question?
I don't know what to tell you. My work right now is extremely difficult, and something like that would just be a complete distraction. But I would like to, you know...
I'm not too much of a distraction that you don't spend every night with me.
Spent deriving and figuring out and dealing with people like Dyson who have ulterior motives. And if, look, the answer is, well, yeah, the answer is yes. Just not right now. Not right now, when I have all this stuff falling on my shoulders. I have so much to come. The fusion core, the asteroid torpedo, these things that need to happen. And I have time just now, just enough for you. And I've been afraid if we did something like that, we'd have to make more time. I hope you understand what I'm telling you. I'm telling you yes. Just not right now.
I see. See, for me, loving you is easy. I guess nothing comes easily for you.
No.
Wait for tonight.
Wait.
I'll see you later, Doctor.
Bye.
The end is the beginning.
Milhouse knows everything. The plot is complete. It's time for him to make his beautiful ascension. It's time for Milhouse to make his ascension.
And I was curious, how are we going to contact him?
Patience, Dr. O'Hara. The President will be joining us soon via the holocam.
The what?
It's a holographic imaging system.
It's used in some of your more tasteless and insidious internet porn. I'm presently trying to have it banned for our children's sake.
Unless, of course, if Fabian continues in his present manner, I may be wasting my time.
Blow it out your own ass.
Excuse me? Pornography has no class.
That's what I thought you said.
The President's ready to see you now.
Very good. The President will be joining us now.
No, that would be stupid. Hello.
I am the President of the United States.
Mr. President.
Raheed Khan, thank you for arranging this meeting.
My pleasure. And my condolences for the recent passing of President Clinton. Most sad.
Well, it's like Clinton said. I feel like I'm smoking two cigars at once.
Oh, yes, indeed. Very funny. Now, about the size of the aid package you will be sending India.
Yes, we have cut the aid package completely.
Oh. Well then.
Mr. President, with the fusion core, we're not supplied with a outline to this meeting. I'm just wondering, why is it called?
My defense secretary has advised me on a potential hazard with the fusion core, and I will not approve of the full power-up until I have some of my questions answered.
That being?
Why is the fusion core operating while it suffers power spikes?
Yes, sir. When the core is fueled, the increase in mass causes the core to spin slower. Hence, the fusion reaction occurs faster.
Would you run that by me again?
The fusion core spins at nearly the speed of light. And as a consequence, time within the fusion core itself, relative to our frame of reference, slows. And in effect, the fusion core burns slower.
But time doesn't stand still.
Yes, sir, it does. It's Einstein's special theory of relativity.
Is he correct? Okay. My science advisor has just confirmed what you said is true. I'm rather suspicious, Dr. Dyson, that this meeting was called on your behalf.
Mr. President, Dr. Dyson is emphasizing this nuance of the fusion core to highlight his own limited claim to the patent.
That's absolutely not true.
Mr. President?
Yes. You are?
Dr. Wallace Wendell and I helped design the fusion core. Now, I know for a fact that this nuance that Dr. Dyson is bringing up is nothing to be concerned with. When the fusion core has momentary spikes in power output due to slowing of the centrifuge, the only necessary thing to do is draw off matter from the fusion core skin, thusly allowing the core to spin faster and retain its nominal burn rate.
I was briefed on a pair of neutrino pulses that were detected last month. Is this related to the fusion core?
No. What you were briefed on was the detonation of an asteroid torpedo-like weapon in the solar system CRMM114, and as a result, we have found two planets that destroyed themselves in mutual annihilation.
Do you mean you have proof of the mutual genocide of two planetary cultures?
In fact, this is the same system that the Delta VI Project has identified as the origin of alien contact. In fact, I could have a detailed report to you about our findings and all the nuances to our theory. However, you might find some of the ideas radical.
Try me.
I'm talking about a worldwide peace movement that coincides with the power-up of the fusion core. I will teach the genocide of war, and Fabian will teach the miracle of the fusion core. Together, we can bring peace to the Earth.
That is absolutely ludicrous, and you know it.
Sir, can we return to the...
Excuse me, did I ask your opinion?
But the issue is not...
Issue, issue.
Mr. President, this is not just a nuisance. This is a glaring design flaw that we must address before full power-up.
I am not in charge of the fusion core. I only have executive power over the money that's being spent by the U.S. And I am not withholding money, either. If you have problems with the design, Dr. Dyson, try resolving them with Dr. O'Hara.
But he will not listen to me!
Will I be getting a report from you soon?
Yes, you will. If you still live at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue.
Thank you. It's been an illuminating night, but I have to go. After all, I am the President of the United States. Yeah.
You have to tell him. You'll feel so much better when you do.
But he's gonna be so disappointed.
Listen, I don't care how far into his PhD Wallace Wyndham is. You don't have to stay with him if you don't want to. Listen, go tell him, and then we'll meet at the coffee shop that we like. Would you like that?
Sure.
Why are you leaving me?
I told you before.
And I told you to tell her to go away.
I can't.
I love you.
And I love you. But I love her too.
Design.
And it convinced me that your design flaw was a harmless side effect.
You crapped out, guys. Now go commit suicide or something.
Regis, how in the hell can you watch this shit?
It's entertaining.
It's garbage, man. This is so stupid.
It's delicious.
Neutrinos are tiny particles that are most commonly...
Well, my mentor, how are you going to play into my plan?
With the asteroid
Don't you mean my plan? Yeah, whatever.
Regis,
popcorn?
Just before
Please.
This is part of the army sequence.
This is extra butter?
Mm-hmm. Critical
I mean, if you're evil, then what the hell?
The
Literally.
The
Drake Dyson
no, let's watch the press
and
interview.
With our mentor, Fabian O'Hara, to design the asteroid torpedo. Delta 6 has traced two neutrino surges to a solar system 42 light years from Earth, CRMM114. The project concluded that approximately 40 years ago, some civilization there picked up radio or TV transmissions from 50s Earth. They replied, the reply taking 42 years to reach Earth. Dr. Rodriguez, who discovered the origin of the Delta 6 transmission, thought that the neutrino surges were another form of contact by those surges. This mainly because the neutrinos travel faster than light and any form of communication.
I'm not watching my weight.
A 42-year turnaround time would be desirable.
You know the story with Jesus Christ? And he takes that fish and like turns it into like 50 fishes? I need to do that like a keg of beer sometime. That would be great. Rock. We gotta worry about this though. Who needs to worry? All the plans are in place. You act like they're your plans. They're my plans. Know your place. I've adopted them and transformed them, and I mean, you've transformed them into squat. Now give me that. Wallace up here is doing all my bidding for him. Doesn't he look like a pretentious ass?
View of what happened. What we know for certain, though, is that two civilizations completely destroyed themselves in interplanetary war, using a weapon of massive potency. And this weapon is the asteroid torpedo. And now I have something to say. With this information,
come on, sir. Where are your manners?
Who cares?
The Fusion Corps will come online in conjunction with a peace movement that I will lead. My friends, the world is ready for a dose of reality. This reality being the genocide of CRMM114. And the world is ready for a miracle. This miracle being the free power that the Fusion Corps will distribute to every person on the planet. Come with me. While I appease man's want for power and cure man's urge for violence. Thank you.
Okay, show's over, man. It's time to go kill Fabian, your mentor. All right, let's do it. I'll meet you there. Hey, Regis. Don't drink it.
Excellent choice.
Thank you.
Skeptical about the Fusion Core and concerned about the neutrino emissions. Should probably tell Dyson about it.
At one time, Dyson raised a point about neutrino emissions and suggested a modification to prevent it. He probably thought if he could bring this to the President's attention, he could get the President to withdraw money from the Fusion Core project.
Fabian, what did you want us to talk about back here in the end? Celebration, my friends. Celebration. Sounds like a good plan to me.
Fabian, my good man, I didn't know you were a connoisseur of the finer champagnes.
Maybe the very finest ones.
We're gonna have glasses for this? We're gonna sip from the same bottle.
Glasses, I think, would be more appropriate.
Well then. Wallace.
Compliments.
And Valeria?
I don't drink.
We'll help you cross then. I wouldn't feel right otherwise.
Fine.
To the Fusion Core.
And world peace.
Here, here.
A little greener than usual.
Valeria! 911 now!
As much as we are devastated by the death of Dr. O'Hara, we are very pleased to see one of his students take over this important project, and to see the Fusion Core will be brought online within the month as planned.
Fusion Core will come online as scheduled.
Am I to understand that you will be taking over the Fusion Core?
No, I'm here for Regis.
It is a tragedy that Fabian O'Hara died, and that it happened so gruesomely. But let's not compound the problem by perpetuating Fabian O'Hara's final mistake. We need to be calm and fully study the Fusion Core. Have you all dealt with the neutrino spikes that occurred twice last month?
Regis has dealt with that.
If you've dealt with the problem, then what is the implemented solution?
What does it matter to you?
Excuse me, ma'am?
We know what you did.
I know. He knows. They all do.
What I did? To accuse me of murder is an atrocity.
Your entire agenda is an atrocity of communist innuendo. Iced over with murder.
Murder, do you say?
Yes, murder, dare I say, you son of a bitch.
I am not a murderer.
Yes, you are.
I am not a murderer.
Yes, you are.
No, I am not.
And R2.
No, I am not.
Yes, you are.
I am not.
You are a filthy murderer. Leave these chambers now.
This is a conspiracy, perpetuated by Wallace Wendell. He got his marching orders from the president yesterday. His mission supposedly being world peace. I know how to use the Fusion Core for world peace. You don't.
What? Communist deception and assassination? That's not world peace.
Given the choice between conformity to world peace or giving up free electrical power, any man would conform.
And that is where you and I differ. I'm going to give the world a choice, and I have a means of showing the world why they should choose me. You would deny them that choice.
You are a communist pig.
Since she left. Are you going to do anything?
I feel so low. I feel so useless.
Wallace, you're no use to me anymore.
Get your stuff and just get out.
Question.
is boosting both the economy and my re-election prospects.
You've already served 2 terms.
Congress is planning to repeal that part of the 22nd Amendment.
A regular FDR, I see.
I like to think so.
Be a lane, would you? The court needs refitting in 5 years.
You can imagine the kind of wear on any engine containing a continuing nuclear explosion. Continue.
All I need is $600 billion allocated to the corporation for new expense.
Won't that be allocated to the United Nations?
It would be impossible for me to get the Grand Debating Society to fork over the money again. I mean, the original war was funded by the 5 permanent members of the Security Council. The UN chipped in $50 billion.
I see your point. $600 billion.
Besides, the Corps will be refurbished by the time you're ready for your 4th election.
You know, as much as you drive a red bargain, I like the way you tell me.
College, you were asked on a date by Ariana. Why didn't you say yes? If that is true, then how can you pinpoint any of the neutrino surges?
$600 billion?
Yes.
You know that not even with a corner on the computer programming business could India so easily dispense $600 billion.
Do you trust the UN to fork over 6 big ones? Or the US for that matter? The Congress is run by a bunch of Republicans.
Yes, the same Republicans who backed the aid package to India, not your president who cut them like a fig tree. It can be done.
Good. Oh, I'm really sorry about that.
You've just insulted my family for the next 12 generations.
Shit.
Dyson.
Christina, we needed to talk to you about my idea of bringing the fusion core online, mixing it with argon and hydrogen,
and
injecting it.
Can I just make a comment? You've lost all your credibility. Dr. Wendell's report not only proves what fool's play your research is, but what an irresponsible scientist you are.
How dare you talk to me like that?
I quit. Johan quit. Your wife quit.
I was hoping that someday you would fill that role.
Damn it! Hello. Dr. Rodriguez. I didn't expect to hear from you. Okay. Meaty, what time? I'll be there. Ciao.
What's the deal with the Fusion Core? You're not taking any of my suggestions. It's just not going to work out. The thing is not going to be ready in time. Plus, you're trying to go 2 months early. Listen, Regis, I just don't know if it's going to work out. You have to be thinking this through, you know that? I'll tell you what.
Dr. Dyson, what do you think your legacy will be?
Thank you.
whoever tap into fusion. The phrase is communism. Cause for international socialism cannot wait for you, you fat ass lie. Again, a Fabian squandering my fusion. Socialism bringing the fusion core online, and I'm with Argon and I know what to do. I will need you to lead back to step on to fight them, to resist you, to impede you, ever so long as you continue to shut me and my message out. The phrase is communism.
Good night, Doctor.
CRMM114 and the last three came from nowhere. Clearly, when I do them all by hand, all five of them fail the test.
Mr. President.
You know, when I was a kid, I wanted to be a doctor, or maybe an engineer, or maybe even a teacher. But when I got to politics, I couldn't stop obsessing over gaining power. When I see someone flood the world diamond market and then make off with $9 trillion before the diamond market collapses, I cannot help but pity this small-minded person.
Most evil people do not think their moves through. Sir, Rodriguez has purchased 1/5 of the total stock traded on Wall Street. He has cornered the arms market with substantial transportation and communication shares.
Sir, we must arrest him.
And how can I legally do that? He's broken no laws.
Antitrust laws. Monopoly laws, sir.
When was the last time a monopoly waged war on its own country? And yet I see him consolidating all this power for himself, and I beg the question of what a man would do with all that power. I truly feel a reckoning is coming, but I cannot up and break the law for what I suspect might happen.
Mr. President, I have evidence right here that none of the neutrino surges are from CRMM114, and that the foundation for Mr. Wendell's peace movement is false. Are you going to say something that means something, or are you going to sit there and play with yourself?
I will remind you that I am the President of the United States.
Then act like you have some balls, and prevent Wallace's stupidity, and prevent Regis from continuing to manipulate the world.
I cannot legally do either, and I do not believe Wallace's movement can be stopped. His movement already has 70 million followers. Issue an arrest warrant for Dr. Rodriguez. I want it before Dr. Wendell leaves for ISO Deltoidistan.
The people will be out here in a few minutes to pick up my stuff and take it to the airport. So, when they come, just let them in.
How long?
Years, perhaps. It is ironic that after I'm out of your life so long, that I'm so quickly leaving yours. I love you. And I want to be back as fast as I can.
Excuse me? Yes?
Don't worry about it, alright?
Whatever.
Come with me.
Are you aware that Regis has solicited over $4 trillion from India, the United States, Trans-Europe, China, Japan, plus 28 other members of the international community?
No.
Regis has purchased De Beers and a Russian diamond mine for $2 trillion.
$2 trillion, Mr. Khan. Do you know whom he has contacted since?
I don't know. I don't know a damn thing, except that I was betrayed.
We will see if the betrayal was yours to suffer or yours to administer. You may leave.
Listen to me now. You're making war, but you must know that war has no rational end. The war you've been making for centuries will never come to an end until both of you are dead. I know of the destruction of two worlds, worlds that were locked into war for centuries, and ultimately, they were destroyed. Come to me. Allow my words to be your peace treaty.
Dr. Rodriguez, can I have a few minutes of your time?
Yes, let's make it quick, though.
How do you feel about Congress impeaching the president for wrongfully imprisoning you as a high crimes and misdemeanors?
I feel it is what's best for the country.
Now that you're in control of the Fusion Corps, what do you plan to do?
I plan on crossing that bridge when time comes.
What does
that mean?
Now,
I will be working with the Vice President, and we will be negotiating...
Don't you mean the current President, because the Vice President was just sworn in as President?
Don't interrupt me, please. That's all, thanks.
Miss Vice President, that was beautiful.
Regis, your friend Wallace has been successful in 7 world hotspots.
The President, innocent or guilty?
Guilty.
That's good news, Miss President.
Thank you, Vice President Rodriguez.
Not for long. May you rest in peace. Regis. You have been more successful than I could possibly have imagined. Now that you're in control of the fusion core, don't you think it needs tending to?
Let someone else do it. One day, I will rule this planet.
Regis, don't do that. You just look stupid. No good. Do I remind you of how I was once long ago?
We have both changed, grown older.
And wiser?
I don't know about that. I can think of one thing, Wallace.
Yes?
I have never known you when you were angry with me. You were never angry at me.
You weren't there for it, but I was.
Repeat after me. I do solemnly affirm.
I do solemnly affirm.
That I will faithfully execute the office of President.
That I will faithfully execute the office of President.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
And will to the best of my ability.
And to the best of my ability.
Preserve.
Preserve.
Protect.
Protect.
And defend.
And defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
Regis has just been named President, and you have just been named Vice President.
be worrying about consolidating your power base.
Perhaps I should consolidate power to myself, beginning with Africa.
Yes. Invade.
And now, this late-breaking story from ABC News, courtesy the BBC.
A tragic affair has just unfolded in the city of London as the President of the United States visited with dignitaries from seven European countries. The President has been assassinated. I repeat, the President is dead. Chief Justice Gary Geraldson has administered the oath of office to Vice President Regis Rodriguez. President Rodriguez will be addressing the nation tonight at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Thank you.
I have intelligence that 12 African nations have conspired to build giant power plants that siphon electricity from the fusion core network and store it in giant capacitors, then in turn sell the power on a worldwide black market for electricity. I have therefore deployed troops onto the USS Enterprise to invade Western Africa. This mission will be dangerous, but I feel it is imperative for securing the safety of the dispensation of power to the world.
This is fundamentally intolerable.
Farewell and bless.
Time to do what?
Regis has made movements toward the Saudi Arabian frontier.
What the hell is going on?
It is Regis. He's attempting to conquer the world. And you, Wallace, have made the world so limp-wristed that they're afraid to raise a hand in his aggression.
Fuck you. You see, at least somebody still has aggression left in his soul.
Touché.
What you have in mind is to kill our president. And we cannot get him to stop using violence by committing violence. If my journey has taught me one thing, it is that peace is bought with peace, not aggression.
You have never seen war or the horror in battle, and I guarantee you that Regis will bring a horror to your front doorstep, the likes that you have never seen. Never seen.
Cheek that he slaps today, I will turn to him to be slapped tomorrow.
You stupid motherfucker!
It was like pushing against the wall, Valeria. He could not see that violence, in this case killing our admittedly corrupt president, would only doom us to death.
Can I talk to you?
Sure.
Wallace, you've used the neutrinos and the two planets as a parable for world peace.
It was a good choice, considering...
No, it was not.
That seems an odd comment to make, given the fact that I have brought to many regions of the world and
Wallace,
ended warfare...
Wallace, the neutrinos did not come from that solar system.
I did the calculations twice, just to be sure.
Valeria,
there are certain principles, Mr. Wendell, that every scientist must follow. This is the culmination of your arrogance. You're using unsound facts to justify world peace. I didn't think that you hadn't checked the information twice first.
Well, excuse me for having ambitions about how to make the world better.
Better? Do you realize what you've done? You have made everyone on this planet so afraid of war that they allow Regis to continue his aggression. You have made a world full of pacifist do-nothings.
If you're so damn clever, then what should we be doing?
Fighting back. No one in the UN seems to care that Regis has taken over Africa and South America. And in fact, the UN is about to hand over the Arabian Peninsula to Regis.
You mean the United States?
No. I mean Regis. He's taken claim over all the territories he's possessed.
This is like a bad dream.
But I am convinced that war will accomplish nothing. If we want to get rid of Regis as president, we must dispose of him the same way we disposed of the last president. We must impeach him.
The last president was murdered.
I mean the one before that. What are you doing?
Erasing the truth, because everyone wants to live in lies.
Oh, Valeria.
Don't hug me. I'm leaving Earth, Wendell.
Then where are you going to go?
Mars. I've taken a research assignment there. I'll be leaving in 2 weeks.
How long are you going to stay there?
For the rest of my life. It's just that I feel almost betrayed that you could be this careless. I believed in you.
But all those things you just said, you couldn't have, you must have meant some of that. That couldn't have all been just pure anger.
I did mean it, but...
Then don't be angry with yourself. If you feel I have castrated the world, then I'm not the right man for you. Don't feel bad.
Wallace? You can still admit your mistake. It will go a great ways into defeating Regis.
That I cannot do. This war you want to have with Regis will only strengthen his position. The only way to defeat Regis is with our ideas, not with our fists. Just let me see you off at the airport, though. I have to go.
Goodbye.
Did you really think that this idea is aggressive enough?
Aggression is not what's needed. Only peace and tranquility can drown out the battle cry that Regis is chanting.
You know that Regis is planning on changing the name of the United States.
Only more cannon fodder for us when we get him convicted in the Senate.
Has the House voted on impeachment?
He was impeached the day he took office. But his hold on power is the control of the Fusion Corps. If we could get him out of control of the Fusion Corps, then his power base would be destroyed.
What will he do as president once Regis is gone?
Resign and administer the Fusion Corps if that's the UN's pleasure. I don't want to be the president of the United States.
What if I'm convicted in the Senate?
Technically, you'd no longer be the president. Well, you could just take over the government and execute the Congress if you wanted to.
No! I can't just wait and see what the Senate does. I think it is time Washington suffers a terrorist attack.
That's so delicious. It's so evil.
Tell me, will it be an onslaught of biogenetic replicas?
No, I don't trust the Raven leader, Carson Kimona. I was thinking something more along the lines of a waste removal system for the Fusion Corps. You know, like that green shit we have to take out every so often.
Actually, waste from the Fusion Corps is fused helium. Sometimes carbon and nitrogen is quite harmless.
Yes, but how many people know that?
A radioactive missile attack.
Actually, I was just thinking we could dump it out the side of an airplane.
Reggie, that would just be boring and stupid.
No, it wouldn't. It has its simplicity and elegance that you should appreciate it. The Fusion Corps has continued to slow? Its mean radiant frequency is 0.5% lower than normal? Let's add more fuel and see if more power won't kick it out of this rut. Yeah. Okay.
Mr. Vice President, your plan is feeble. The President is completely insane. A vote in the Senate will not be enough.
Let me ask you this. Is our military so weak that they will act idly out of the President's will without first considering their actions? No, I think not. Just remember that they went into Africa only with the fabricated proof of the African capacitors. The African capacitors that were supposedly sucking off of fusion.
Regis will not respect anything given from the UN or Congress.
That is why we have to turn to the legal means for removing the President, because he will not willfully step down.
Then you will control both the presidency and the fusion core.
No. I'm going to resign once I have been named president. Least you forget that I did not want to be named vice president.
But why would you want to do that? You could advance your peace agenda from such a lofty position.
Would Christ have been an appropriate Caesar? No, I think not.
The president is not a Caesar.
Which is why I cannot use the presidency to advance my agenda. I must advance world peace as Dr. Wallace Wendell, not as a president.
We will move to convict Regis after he's been removed from control of the fusion core.
That's a good idea. Mr. Next President.
I do not understand him.
He's a physicist.
My sin was too much peace too soon, Valeria. I never thought that if the world became sheep that my former pupil would become a wolf. But it is done, and the world will be better off for it in the long run. Here's one more thing, Valeria. There has been a sixth neutrino surge and has been continuing for 2 weeks now without any identified origin. Could the Mars station please take a look into it?
Sure thing, Wallace.
All right, bye.
Control the world. The African campaign, your arguments for the world and the power, it's all based on lies. There is no capacitor, is there, Mr. Rodriguez?
Do you know who I have on my side?
I don't care.
The UN has been bamboozled by your fascist schemes no more. You and Dyson are menaces. The world will no longer suffer.
Resign, Mr. Rodriguez.
And let Wally Wendell be president?
Please.
Regis.
many people have you murdered to get your job? How many of my friends have you killed?
Only one.
Regis, you're under arrest.
Move and he dies.
Mr. President?
What?
Been impeached.
Regis, you have failed my legacy.
Crappy eraser. Doesn't erase anything.
I was thinking about something that happened a long time ago.
What's that? I love you too, Wallace.
Mr. Donaldson, when will we bring the particle detector online?
In T-minus 5 minutes.
Tell me when it goes online. I'll be writing a message. Computer, diction.
Hello.
I just stopped by to apologize about what had happened and to thank you for giving me my job back because
mm-hmm.
I was under a lot of pressure and things just didn't go the way I wanted it to go and I would have made different decisions, but I'm really happy that you gave me my job
mm-hmm.
back because I really need the money because my mom's been sick and it was just heartbreaking when I was fired and I just didn't know what I was going to do. I was looking through the classifieds and I was circling everything, looking at every job. I even applied at, yeah.
Jean, if you want to do something for me, I'm expecting a message from Valeria.
Mm-hmm.
Would you please go to the answering machine and wait for the message? They'll be powering up the particle detector in a few minutes.
Okay.
and I would really like to hear what she has to say about this neutrino discharge that I don't know anything about.
Okay, do you want me to bring it to you?
Yes, that would be very nice of you.
Okay, I'll see you in a little bit.
All right, and bring me a cup of coffee, too.
Do you want cream?
No.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yep. Bye.
Dr. Jones.
Ma'am, the particle detector is online.
Very good. Do a neutrino sweep. When I was back on Earth, there was a mysterious neutrino source that no one could seem to pinpoint.
Right. Oh. My. God.
What is it?
Look at this.
Computer, diction.
Why don't you guys just let me in on the joke?
Tell me what the punchline is.
The end is the beginning.
Regis! Thank you.
heckle.
But I always know the ratchet tech, so I decided to meet you, get you on the way.
Wallace.
Wait. Why are you leaving me?
I told you earlier.
And I told you to tell her to go away.
I can't.
But I love you.
the hell is this shit?
Pedestrian preoccupations of mankind have failed the pragmatic test.
Hope you're alright. It's been rough for me, thinking all night about the places I'd be. If I maybe just did a little bit more, you might have let me become a man for sure. And if I might express one concern, seems an issue all day and every turn. What's the next step, the latest haul of my life? What's left for me to learn? What's left for me to burn? Beauty and oblivion intersect at pragmatism. Pragmatism. Pragmatics. The art of being useful. The art of being practical. And the art of being beautiful. Ah, my dear chums, but you see, beauty and oblivion go hand in hand. And that is where modern pragmatism comes into the fold.
Yeah. All right. One more time.
How's it going?
Good.
So, we're filming episode 3.
Episode 3.
Star Wars.
Oh, I was here once a long time ago.
With whom?
Well, it was Ariana. You look nice to him, by the way.
Thank you.
What?
You look like a square.
Like a square. Thank you. Makes me feel a lot better about myself.
So, this is...
Have you had any more thought about what the neutrino surges were?
Well, Regis gave us his theory today.
And...
Delta 6, the alien communication project, has located CRMM-114 as the source.
I was in talking to Jean. She'd like got off the phone with you or something. And I asked her to look at the system and investigate like any discrepancies between, say, the gravity beforehand, and the gravity after the neutrino surges.
Yes, like, she did find one. It was CRMM-114.
The pieces are like coming together in my mind. Do you know anything about something called an asteroid torpedo?
It is a nuclear weapon designed to destroy asteroids.
It is basically a fusion core that's allowed to go critical. Think of the fusion skin being the spoon. And what we got here is all the hydrogen goes up here like this, and if you put in more and more fuel, the fusion line will go critical and explode. This critical reaction, it produces an explosion that ranges between
700... I understand the nuclear physics. What?
It's just that there, guys like to charm ladies with their wits. And it seems like... Well, it just seemed like when I was trying to do that just now, you cut me off.
It's fun.
I'm not sure how to take that. Not quite sure how to take that.
Where is that waiter?
Also, one more thing. Before I forget, I had a something
Before
I wanted
to forget. Tell me about Ariana.
How may I serve you this evening?
I'll have the smoked salmon.
Very good.
French cod.
Excellent choice, sir.
The house always wins.
Okay, class. Dr. Milhouse is not going to grace your presence for the rest of the hour, so he's going to leave you with some interviews that he did for NBC, CBS, and the Today Show. Let us enjoy.
Stanley Kubrick didn't know shit, man. Steven Spielberg? He's a fucking hack who's all out for capitalist gains. No, real truth is in subjectivity, man. It's all in this pill, yeah. You gotta take the pill and just go and let your mind wander into the depths of oblivion. That's where all truth is, man. That's where beauty lies.